everyone! All right, before we start this week, I have a riddle for you. What do you get when you cross your favorite photos, three sheets of white paper, some inks, and a single stamp set? A two-page layout that looks awesome. Let's get started. This week's layout inspiration comes straight from the pages of one of my favorite magazines, Creating Keepsakes. Recently, they started putting in this awesome section in the center that's actually a pullout. All right, so I look at the sketch here, and then I can also flip over to page 55 in this magazine where it shows her layout and how she executed it. Here's a closer look at the layout that we're going to do. Basically, the main elements that I see in the page are a large main photo on the one page, a title and some journaling below it, and on the other page, a square-shaped or rectangular grid using square-shaped photos. The inspiration for much of my layout design comes from this photo. I see three elements in it that work really well with the stamp set. I see water, I see sand and grass, and I see clouds. It just so happens that the True Happiness stamp set has all three of these elements. I have water, clouds, grass, and I'm going to use some sponging to get some sand. I'm going to work on my journaling block first. I'm using this row of waves that I'm going to put at the block. Now, the Twilight ink is a really pretty color, but if I stamp it first generation, meaning immediately from the stamp pad, it's a little bit too intense of a color. So I'm going to stamp it off once on a scrap piece of paper and then stamp it onto my journaling block here. And then I'm going to stamp it one more time. Stamp it off first and line it up. The nice thing about this stamp set is that it does line up seamlessly end to end. For the title block, I'm going to be doing a little bit more embellishment because I'm only going to have a small title. What I'd like to do is I've imitated the water on the lower journaling block, and now I'd like to imitate the sand and the grass that's in my inspiration picture, as you can see here. Kind of a beachy day. So I'm going to be using my bamboo, desert sand, and sweet leaf inks. I'm going to start by using a sponge, and I'm just going to very, very gently sponge up the background. And if I just dab in a little bit and just pounce it onto the surface, I kind of get a grainy, sandy look, similar to a beach. Okay, so I've got kind of a sandy background, and now I'm going to use this grass stamp and the sweet leaf ink, and I'm going to stamp using both first and second generation stamping. So, going to first start with just some first generation, and then I can go immediately into second generation, so long as I haven't gone off the edge of the stamp, or off the edge of the paper rather. See, if I have my paper lined up like this, and I stamp here, and then I move it and stamp over here, what's going to happen is this part here that didn't stamp on the paper, it's not going to lose the same amount of ink. And when you stamp it over here, you're going to get half light and half dark, or half dark and half light, depending on how the ink may or may not have been taken off of this side. So when you're doing second generation stamping, you want to make sure that you always stamp off evenly. So I'm going to stamp off here. And then I'm going to just make a little line kind of in the background here. And it's super light, but it's just the effect I'm looking for. Now, what I also wanted to do is I also found that the grass in the photo is kind of a brownish color as well. So I'm also going to use some of my bamboo ink to add some different color tones into there. Okay, so here's an idea of what my title's background is going to be. I've got kind of the sandy effect. I've got some layers of grass with the bamboo and the sweet leaf. The one thing I'm going to do before I continue is, just because this is a white strip of paper and it's going to be adhered to a white daisy piece of cardstock, I'm going to add just the thinnest line of distressing. And I'm not even going to swipe it, I'm just going to kind of rub it straight across just to give it the thinnest little outline. The other thing I need to add to my layout is a title, and the True Happiness set comes with a title block. I'm going to ink up my stamp and stamp it off once, Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do rock and roll. So I'm going to keep that ink that was just on, and I'm going to roll my stamp. And so what I have is second generation stamping in the middle of the block and first generation stamping on the outside. So there you can see. Okay, so I've cut out my little title block, and you can also see that I've just run it again along the Twilight ink pad just to give it a little bit of differentiation from the background that it's going to be on. And I'm going to just adhere that kind of off to the left side. And it's just been popped up a little bit with some dimensional, so it has a little bit of a 3D effect. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my quilting ruler, and this is an example of how handy it is, and I'm going to draw a line starting at 2 inches from the edge and 3/4 of an inch in from the edge, and I'm just going to draw an 8-inch line. So I start at 2 and head all the way up to 10, and I'm just drawing this with a pencil because what I'd like to do is I'd actually like to go back and freehand it, well, freehand it over top of the pre-drawn line, just so it gives it an idea. Air of kind of impulsivity, but doesn't mess with my anal retentive desire to be straight and accurate. So I've done 2 8-inch lines, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to connect those with my quilting ruler again. Okay, so that's page one just done. Show you around a little bit. I've penciled in some lines on my journaling block. I've run around the edge in a corresponding marker color, and everything is adhered and it's ready to go. It's a really minimalist design, but I think it just highlights a really beautiful photo really well. And I think that when you have a photo that you love, that you shouldn't clutter up your page too much. So let's move on to the second page. Okay, so referring back to our original sketch, you'll also notice that this is an 8.5 by 11 layout, and I'm using it as a 12 by 12. So you see I have more white space on the sides of the central element. As well, you're going to notice that Ali has put 6 square photos in a vertical orientation, and what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to switch that around into horizontal orientation. So I've got my photos laid out, and basically it's just the simplest little thing I'm going to do to start out with. I'm going to draw in my pencil line around it, erase it lightly, and go over it with my marker color, and that's going to be basically all I'm adding to this page, other than the embellishments that I'm going to balance out afterwards. So I'm going to do that and I'll be right back. Okay, so I've drawn my outline to kind of frame my photos, and I've adhered them to the page. Just to remind you, the photos are 3 by 3 squares. They're separated by 1/4 of an inch. The border is 1/2 inch around those. So basically the border here is 3/4 of an inch from each side. So next what we're going to do is we're going to create some accent pieces using the clouds, and I'm going to be stamping them in both the crystal blue and the twilight. Clouds out, and I haven't cut them out in strips. I've cut them out some in individual clouds and a small group, and I'm just going to adhere 2 of them directly to the page with my Tombow, and then the other ones I have added some dimensional to the bottom of, and I'm just going to layer those over top of the others just at the top of this photo here. So we have again a little bit of dimension on this page. So I've got my page 1 and page 2. I've got some similar elements on both pages that I've kind of carried through, and I've talked about that before. Got photos on both pages, some stamped elements on both pages, I've popped something up on both pages, I've framed things on both pages, so I think that these layouts have balance and unity, and I really think they're done. So I'm going to call this done, and if you feel like this is a waste of time, well, hopefully a later video might catch your interest a little bit more. Anyways, it's been nice scrapping with you, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to email me or leave a note in the comments. Thanks for watching. Bye!